What's up, guys? Back with the third video and the third hour of starting the third hour of our day two grind, the $210 mystery bounty. And what I did is I checked the remaining prices and I added them. So I really added everything here, 3 times 49k. Or maybe I only put one in. Well, it doesn't make a very big difference, but yeah. So I added all the prices. I will try it again, just to make sure I didn't make a big mistake. So that's the remaining prices left, $60,500. And now we divide it by the remaining players, which is 1,135. And that's the average. That's the value of one bounty. So we should play according to the math, of course, it's poker. And that means if we consider calling, like maybe an edgy situation, that's what we can expect on average, a bounty of $574 and a few cents. So that's not very much. That means in the beginning it was almost double. That means all the good ones are gone, as we can see here, and even from like there, like it's really the best stuff is already gone mostly. So now the bounties become less and less important because ICM value of our stack is increasing and increasing. And so it makes sense to play less focused on just grabbing a bounty. Yeah. So that's an interesting part. I will try to recalculate it again. Maybe I made a mistake, like I said, 3 times 49k. Actually don't have to put it in totally exact, but yeah, let's do it. Plus 4 times 35k. Plus 24. Plus 48. Like here, 4 times, plus 90k, plus 11 times, 5,300, plus 18 times 5,000. I can raise or fold this, I'm gonna fold it. Pretty clear fold, I think. 18 times 5, 23 times 2,300. Oops. 23 times. Okay, maybe I forgot a little bit before. Plus 49,000. Plus. This one plus this one. Okay, I think I miscalculated a little bit before. Oops. Plus 81 times 600. Okay, and now divided by. So yeah, the value is actually 700. That's very interesting with him doing that so often. I almost want to regem. This is even a call, because if an ace comes, I'm having trouble and he's stealing so much that I don't want to go crazy with ace 8. It's a nice float, but we are not deep enough to float here a lot. And it's a strange turn. Because him checking here means a lot of ace X. Him betting so tiny. Probably have to call, and if the river breaks, or it's just. I mean, he's checking a lot of. He's checking a lot of strong ace X here, but sometimes we should. Oh, that's very nice. That's beautiful. Yes! I want the chips! Give me all of them! So sorry for everybody who didn't buy my steak. But yeah, of course, super lucky with the 5.3k. But I mean, yeah, pretty cool. Three bounties, one 180, 181, and one 5.3k. Interesting forex, just flatting here. That's a nice set mining position. Problem is, if he rejams and he calls, I can still call. That's very close. Forex, that's so crazy. Just folding the king 3 here. Don't want to do anything too weird. Actually, he's out of. Yeah. I could think about stealing, actually, if everybody folds to me. He's not too active here. He will be very tight. And now I think I'm just gonna fold. Too difficult to play, depending on what comes on the turn. We could be quite dead already, and yeah. It's a little bit nitty to fold this flop, but I think it's fine. Stealing so much. Unfortunate that my 9-7 suited 3-bet didn't get through. I mean, sometimes people also have crazy stats just because they run hot. You're getting jacks, aces, kings, ace-king all the time. That happens rarely, but it happens. And then it could look like you're a total maniac, but you're just getting cards. It doesn't happen often, of course the stats say a lot, but you shouldn't put like all your play into one basket. Maybe he's just very aggressive. Seeing this one, interesting flop, he still has some backdoors. Ooh, I really hope his queens hold. Would be so nice, like 1.9 1.9 stack. It's really nice. Let's get a good spot here. Would be cool. Kings maybe. Ace and suited is interesting enough. Like I told you guys, the bounties are not worth so crazy much. So I think this is just a race fold even against him. This is close. I wonder what it is against him. I think it's a race call against him, but it's very close. Not a happy call against him, of course. Not at all. Why do things always have to happen in the way you don't want them to happen? Yeah, I think it's a call, but it's very close. I mean, we're getting 2-1. That's like so good. Hopefully he just... Oh! Yeah, that's bottom of his reshuffling range, I think. Let's hold, please. Very bad. GGG. I mean, he has great equity against this hand. Makes sense. Yeah, now we just have a shove a fold stack. Yeah. I hope he folds. He probably doesn't. Let's see. We have to fold. Just jamming here. Poker is so funny, if you bust now it still doesn't feel great, even though it of course is a super great day. And I'm not saying it feels bad, don't get me wrong. I'm just saying, if you're a tournament player, anything besides a top finish, usually just in the moment, doesn't feel fantastic. Even though it might be a super big score. That's so great that he/she folded. Isn't that American... foreign minister or some Sarah Palin or someone? I'm not sure. So let's see. Yeah, equity shouldn't have changed too much. The big prices are still the same, almost. There are a little less left, but. I think that's just a fault. Unfortunately. Yeah. Oh, we had so much equity. Yeah. Yeah, the fault is still good. Too many players to act. They're probably all light. If he falls, that would be so funny, but that would be the stupidest move I've ever seen. You need to take the pot outs here. Just hope you quadruple up. Yeah, he's probably doing that, just tanking for the money bump, I guess, but he probably won't get there. Now we have no one covered on the table, that sucks. It's not a mega biggie, but it's still annoying. He just has the king, must be nice. What's it gonna be? 180. Yeah, better than the min cash. King 10, probably calling small blind shove. Do I? Yeah, I think I have to. Do I defend this? I think I have to. Again, 9, so I'm gonna play post flop here. Well, actually, I think I'm gonna raise this. He has a high incentive to steal a lot here on this table with one sitting out, one bounty. Oh, what the heck? Yeah, I have to defend. Sure, it sucks to get re-raised. He really knows what he's doing. That's the perfect sizing, actually, on this board. Just gonna fold. Do I? No, I think I have to peel one. That's a really great turn. He has a lot of ace-x here that he probably just gonna jam. And he should bet this turn. I mean, he probably thinks I'm gonna. He's probably not falling to a jam here. I'm just gonna call it. Two big blinds. Oh my god, you're just getting the price. You're so priced in. He knows this is either a check or a very strong hand that I'm not folding. I don't know if he can still find the trigger. Probably he should, given that I check back on the river. I'm blocking all the nuts here, but yeah, I mean, he has the queen 10 here sometimes, but we are blocking all that stuff a lot. I mean, it can be a bluff. Just very unlucky run out, I think. Well, unlucky in a way that I don't get away from that. And I think the flop call is still okay. Pre-flop call is kind of borderline. Flop call is kind of borderline. Turn call, I think, is mandatory. And river fold is also close, but yeah. Sucks to have 5 big blinds only, but yeah. He had a very strong channel. What can I say? Like, he could have had a full house or something there. Like, his perceived range is very, very strong on that board. Wow, nice. Something in my eye, sorry. Okay, we need a spot. I hope I don't blind to death. Not much wiggle room left. Still an exciting grind. I mean, it's not over yet, and I don't know, should I continue just showing this one tournament here? The last king on the flop, 100%. Let me know what you think about this hand. I think it's actually one of the more interesting ones, because you can always make a case for jamming flop. It, I think it's kind of crazy, but you can do it. But I think against the one big blind c-bet, this is just a call here with all the backdoor. And then the turn. I mean, if it would be a queen, I would probably re-jam if he brings the two big blind bet on the queen here. But then we have even better odds to peel. So I think the check call makes the most sense. I'm not a big fan of it normally. I want to take my fold equity, but given his range advantage on especially this turn. Yeah, I think on the queen you have to jam and close your eyes. Occasionally running into a check full house, checks full of sevens. Deja vu, same hand, exactly the same. Very unlikely. Yeah, now we can't even blind it down for another money bump. Even though it's a nice one now, it's over $100. Yeah, we have to get it in with a marginal hand most likely and pray. But these are not the hands you want to do it with. Maybe 6-7 suited can do it, but we are getting called by almost 100% on the big blind with our stack size, so maybe you still have a tiny bit of fold equity against players like him. Most likely not. I think they actually are supposed to call like 100% here. Or maybe it's like 95% or something. Yeah, not good enough. 10-9 off, I might consider. But probably 10-9 off is still a fold. 10-9 suited, jam. Bam, bam, bam. It would suck to get the blind through us. At least the blinds are not increasing before we are in them. Unless they take ours now and tank. Very tiny bet, very interesting actually. Yeah, I'm gonna steal here because I want to get these tiny bounty guys. Oh my god. Ugh. Question is, I'm gonna check this and bet turn. I think it looks stronger against the stack size unless he starts plonking heavy. Yeah, easy. I think he defends a lot of a6 here and plays it that way. How many hands? Hello. Yeah, yeah, with his stats, that's... Check 5, I can't even defend. I think... Could think about calling his all-in, but yeah. Just holding here, it sucks. King X here. It's a bad turn. It's a good river. Gonna bet for value here. Maybe we should actually aim for the min for the next bump. He's just getting total bullshit. 10-5, I can't shove this one. Should I go into tank mode? Because yeah, it's annoying to watch, I'm sorry, but I should think about it. It's a little bit close. $100 more. Yeah, I will tank a little bit here, yeah. I could jam this too. I feel like he might be trapping now a little bit more than before. Because the blinds will probably be increased in 4 minutes when we are in big blind again, so it doesn't make any difference. And now the value of getting $140 more is kind of not too bad. Gonna check here, I don't think I can get a bluff through too much. King X might call us for sure. He might chop against some 10-9 hands, 9-8 hands. Yeah. Should just jam. Queen 9 suited, I'm not folding, I guess. Yeah, now I'm not folding. Good luck, us. I'm on it, but can't fold it here. Question is, do I re-raise? I guess I have to, yeah. Unless, if he re-raises, I think this can become a fold again. I think even tanking now doesn't make sense. We have no chance to get there. A little bit tanking, like, just until my my time bank starts. Yeah, good luck. GL. He should overcall a lot because he can't re-raise. Maybe jam them, like... Ace-5 suited would be a nice jam. Oh, that's very interesting. It looks super strong. The question is it super strong? I hope he just folds. If he re-jams, this could be two monsters, or at least one monster, most likely. Okay, this looks... Well, let's see. This looks a lot like a medium Broadway, a weak ace that he's thinking, should I call or not? I don't think he would have jammed his aces and kings or whatever now. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. Unlucky, I guess. Ooh, best flop you can imagine almost. That's a nice turn. Let's just get there. We have so many odds. Come on, guys. So much money in the pot, I mean. Okay. GG, was nice while it lasted. Such a good flop, damn. And the turn also very, very good. Yeah, that's amazing. Nice cash. Let's see what he gets. And then I'll probably stop it here. I could continue with this one, but it will be a very slow tournament. And it's probably a little too boring to watch. I think I'm gonna continue to stream until we reach one table. I don't know if you guys want that. I think I'm gonna stop now. And if we deep again, I'm gonna stream again. Anyways, guys, remember to subscribe if you haven't, because I'm gonna make a tiny giveaway for something that most poker players probably like on this channel. For every subscriber we have, I will write in the comment to this video what exactly I'm giving away and when the deadline is that you need to be subscribed to my channel. So I will make a like a draw. There are some tools, I think, where you can draw from your subscriber list. I hope there is, I'm not sure. So if that's not possible, I'm sorry. I will try to find another way that's kind of fair, but yeah. So that's the plan. Thanks very much for watching. Leave a comment if you want. It's good for the algorithm, and I also like to discuss poker related stuff a lot. And good luck at the tables. Maybe see you guys on this final table here, hopefully in a later episode, but most likely not. And yeah, have a great day. Bye bye.